So we're heading off to Louis with BT Tours, and here's all the guys here with us. There are about seven of us. Should be a good trip.
First coffee stop for the day. Beautiful big teak building. With a drag bike underneath.
So, jetzt guckt er mal den Namen an. Das heißt, Roland Vogel nur die Fuchter ein bisschen verdreht.
We are a bit outnumbered today. There's four Germans, two Aussies, and one Thai. And tomorrow there's going to be five Germans. Holy smokes.
Now I've been happy lately, thinking about the good things to come, and I believe it could be something good has begun. Oh, I've been smiling lately, dreaming about the world at one, and I believe it could be someday it's going to come. 'Cause out on the edge of darkness, there rides a peace train.
So,
hey, look, what's this stuff here, Chris?
Yeah, what?
Going here.
That's cassava.
Cassava.
Tapioca.
Tapioca.
Tapioca. I think it's the same as this.
And it make starch. Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. They're drying it out in the sun.
Yeah.
So when they spread it out, you see some huge concrete places.
Yep.
We pass through.
Yep. Yeah. 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 I've stopped.
They're spreading all that out and drying it out.
Yeah.
And then they, whatever, selling it and
it's a big crop here, isn't it?
Crushing it or grinding it and then making some tapioca starch out of it.
Must be as big as rubber because they're everywhere, aren't they?
This country, come take me home again. God, smiling me.
Everything's very burnt down here. All the mountains have been burnt.
Now we've reached Saloon Bar Loy. So now five Germans.
Things to come, and I believe it could be something good has begun. Oh, peace train sounding louder. Ride on the peace train.
Okay, they tell me these toilets are very good, so I've got to have a look and see what they're talking about. The ladies one looks all right. So this is the men's. Ooh, very nice. I think this might be it. Wow, look at that. The men's toilet. How about that? Yeah. Wow. Very nice.
We have a guy who's tapping the trees.
Yeah.
So normally he does it every evening, or at least every second evening. Or two nights in a row, and then he's resting one day, and then again 2 days in a row. So he's tapping the trees in the night, because you hurt the tree when you tap him with a knife. So the tree wants to seal the wound that the rubber comes out.
Yeah, yeah,
it's just like the same you cutting yourself. So your body try to close it. So that's what happens. So the tree absorbs the rubber. So then it runs down the groove on a small metal anchor and drops into the bowl.
Right.
So it's running maybe something like 3 hours, 4 hours, depending on the moisture, depending on the heat. So that's the reason why they're doing it at night. So what, the tree takes longer to heal, so it means the rubber runs out longer. You could tap them in day, but the amount will be maybe 50. Oh, at the moment we have like 18 and a half baht or 19 baht if you're lucky at the moment.
Yeah. Yeah, that's it. Come on, the peace train. Get peace train, holy roller. Everyone on the peace train. This is actually an ancient temple. Come on, the peace train. Get your bags together. Go bring your good friends too. Cause it's getting nearer. It soon will be with you. Come and join the living. It's not so far from you. And it's getting nearer. Soon it will all be true. Oh, peace train sounded louder. Slide on the peace train. It is. Why must we go on hating? Why can't we live in bliss? Cause out on the edge of darkness, there rides a peace train. Oh, peace train, take this country. Come take me home again. Oh, peace train sounding louder. Not on the peace train. Come on, the peace train. Yes, peace train. Everyone jump on the peace train. Come on, come on, come on. Yes, come on, peace train. Yes, it's the peace train.